This is module 6 ether channel. In this module, we'll describe the ether channel technology, we'll configure ether channel, troubleshoot ether channel. Ether channel operation. Ether channel is a link aggregation technology. There are scenarios in which more bandwidth or redundancy between devices is needed than what can be provided by a single link. However, STP, take note STP, if you remember, it blocks redundant path. So it, providing more bandwidth by having multiple redundancy will, it's like a conflict with the STP rules. So in a way for the STP will not block the redundant link, so the switch be able to see that those redundant links are in one. Okay, so that's the use of the link aggregation. So it what we do is we bundle multiple physical ports, creating a single logical link. So that's the keyword for the ether channel. It's a link aggregation technology that groups multiple physical Ethernet links together into a one single logical link. Since now it looks like one link or connection, then it will never be the other links or physical links will not be blocked. So it is used to provide fault tolerance, load sharing, also increased bandwidth, and yes, you have physical redundancy between switches, routers, and servers. So in the ether channel technology, it makes it possible to combine number of physical links between switches to increase the overall speed of switch-to-switch communication. So again, like in here, so like these two, diba, these two here, this one is considered redundant. So with STP, it will be blocked. So in a way for STP not to block this, so the switch should be able to see this as one. So that's the use of the ether channel. Okay, so that's the purpose of the ether channel, to bundle multiple physical ports into one single logical link. Advantages: most configuration tasks can be done on the ether channel interface instead of on each individual port, ensuring configuration consistency throughout the links. Ether channel relies on existing switch ports. There is no need to upgrade the link to a faster and more expensive connection to have more bandwidth. And load balancing takes place between links that are part of the same ether channel. Ether channel creates an aggregation that is seen as one logical link. And when several ether channel bundles exist between two switches, STP may block one of the bundles to prevent switching loops. And when STP blocks one of the redundant links, it blocks the entire ether channel. This blocks all the ports belonging to that ether channel link. And when there is where there is only one ether channel link, all physical links in the ether channel are active because STP sees only one logical link. Ether channel provides redundancy because the overall link is seen as one logical connection. Additionally, the loss of one physical link within the channel does not create a change in the topology. So in the implementation, there are things to consider, like how many Ethernet ports you can configure. It should, the maximum, it consists only up to 8 compatibly configured Ethernet ports. So what we mean by compatibly is that you can bundle if they have same bandwidth. Also, the mode should be in full duplex. Okay, so that's how it is. For example, for Ether channel, you can only provide up to, so for fast Ethernet, you can only provide up to 800 Mbps. You can only like bundle 8 physical fast Ethernet ports. For Giga, you can, the maximum is up to 8 gig. That's how it is. So for Cisco 2960 layer 2 switch, it currently supports only up to 6 Ether channels. And then each individual Ether channel group member port configuration must be consistent on both devices. Also, if the physical ports of one side are configured as trunk, the physical port on the other side should also be trunk and has the same native VLAN. And each ether channel has a logical port channel interface. There are two means of configuring ether channel. You may set up a PAGP, port aggregation protocol, which is Cisco proprietary, or a link aggregation control protocol, which is an IEEE standard. So in PAGP, again, this is a Cisco proprietary, meaning you can only see this protocol or this setup in a Cisco switch. It aids in the automatic creation of ether channel links. So actually has the same concept with LACPI, or Link Aggregation Control Protocol. So in PAGP, packets are sent between Ether channel capable ports to negotiate the forming of a channel. And when PAGP identifies match Ethernet links, it groups the links into an Ether channel. And the Ether channel is then added to the spanning tree as a single port. So PAGP packets are usually sent every 30 seconds. So there are modes in this operation. We have on, desirable, and auto. So in order for an Ether channel to establish, so as for the mode for Ether channel to establish, so both sides should be on, or both sides should be desirable, or desirable auto, or auto desirable. Okay. So those are the consideration for an Ether channel to establish. For LACPI, the modes available are on, active, and passive. So again, this is an IEEE standard. Usually, you can see this also on other vendors, not like Cisco. So again, it's in a multi-vendor environment. But Cisco supports both PAGP and LACPI. Okay. So like, if you were to configure switch, so if you use LACPI here, LACPI also should be set up here. You cannot like, it can never be, also it will not work, that say you have a mode here for LACPI and the other side is PAGP, it will not work. So because of this table, so like both should be on, another is should be both active, or active passive, or passive active. So those are the different options for you to establish an aggregation or Ether channel. So to configure an Ether channel, first thing is the BS switch should provide support for the Ether channel. It should be having the same speed and duplex. There should be like native VLAN should match, and then also consider the range of the VLANs. So I'll have a separate video discussions for configuring. I'll have a demonstration for configuring the Ether channel. So again, things to consider should have the same speed, same duplex, same VLAN, native VLAN to be exact. And this is the configuration. It's actually easy. First, you go to the port where you are to bundle. You set up the mode here by typing in channel group. This is the port channel. So, like example, you have port channel 1 should match here. And then you define the mode, same mode active. Then you create the port channel, interface port channel, and then the channel number. You set this up as a trunk. You may also set up a native VLAN. And then if you want to only specifically allow with what VLANs are to pass into the onto this port channel or to this trunk, then you may do that as well. Verify troubleshoot Ether channel. So you may type show interface port channel or show Ether channel to identify those ports that were bundled by the Ether channel. And also show Ether channel port dash channel and show interface Ether channel. These are different show commands we have in the Ether channel. And to summarize, again, to increase bandwidth or redundancy, multiple links could be connected between devices. However, SCP will block redundant links to prevent switching loops. So Ether channel is a link aggregation technology that allows redundant links between devices that will not be blocked by SCP. Ether channel groups multiple physical Ethernet links together into one single logical link. It provides fault tolerance, load sharing, increased bandwidth, and redundancy between switches, routers, and servers. When an Ether channel is configured, the resulting virtual interface is called a port channel. So an Ether channel can be formed through negotiation using one of two protocols, PAGP or LACPI. These protocols allow ports with similar characteristics to form a channel through dynamic negotiation with adjoining switches. When an Ether channel link is configured using Cisco proprietary PAGP, PAGP packets are sent between Ether channel capable ports to negotiate the forming of a channel. And LACPI performs a function similar to PAGP with Cisco Ether channel because LACPI is an IEEE standard and can be used to facilitate Ether channels in multi-vendor environments. Modes for LACPI are on, then LACPI active and LACPI passive. And all Ethernet interfaces on all modules support Ether channel with no requirements that interfaces can be physically contiguous or on the same module. We configure all interfaces in the Ether channel to operate at the same speed and same duplex. All interfaces in the Ether channel bundle must be assigned to the same VLAN. And all Ether channel supports the same allowed range of VLANs on all the interfaces in a tracking Ether channel. And I have here the three steps for configuring an Ether channel, which I have just discussed a while ago. And this ends this module of Ether channel. I'd like to thank you for listening. Keep safe. Together we learn as one.